Hello, my name is Sister Beverly Raway, and I'm a member of St. Scholastica Monastery. I'm honored to present and welcome you to the first topic of the Governance Formation Program of St. Scholastica Monastery on Leadership Formation, a call to continual transformation. Congratulations to all of you for beginning the Governance Formation Program. And thank you for your participation in the conversations around these important topics. Thank you for your leadership role in the Benedictine ministries and your commitment to live out the mission and values of the sisters wherever you serve every day. This unit is the first of 6 units in Volume 1 that are common to each of our sponsored ministries. Your organization has been invited to develop 6 more units that are specific to your ministry for Volume 2 of the Governance Formation Program. The subtitle of this unit, A Call to Continual Transformation, is really the main message of this unit and of the whole program. As leaders in the Ministry of Healthcare, Higher Education, and other services of the Benedictine Sisters of St. Scholastica Monastery, you have responded not only to a call to ministry, but also to an experience of personal transformation in your leadership role. We have deliberately chosen the word formation rather than continuing education to describe this process. Education is an appropriate term to describe the knowledge, skills, and information that need to be passed on to effectively carry out your roles as leaders and board members. Formation involves the passing on of knowledge, but it also carries a deeper meaning. The work of formation calls for personal reflection that leads to actions consistent with the mission and values. In words modified from the CHA website, the formation and development of leaders is an ongoing, multifaceted process that enables leaders to know and confidently act on behalf of the mission of the church's ministries. Through this process, leaders grow in their abilities to guide organizations in a manner that gives witness to gospel values. Formation engages at multiple levels, including the heart as well as the mind, and leads to personal transformation. The world around us is changing rapidly. We need to be ready for that change, but in these times of change, there is also a need for stability. This is a time to stand firm on foundational values that do not change, and to communicate these values authentically as leaders from your own deep well of self-understanding, life experiences, and personal spirituality. In this process, we hope that your commitment and investment of time and energy will lead to renewal so that you can convey to others the excitement and joy of being a leader in one of our sponsored ministries. We are grateful for your response to this sacred call to serve others. We hope that as part of this series of units, you will explore and share with others your own stories of how you experienced your call to ministry and the unique gifts, talents, and skills that you bring to further the mission and ministry of the sisters. We hope further that as a part of this sacred call, you hear the invitation to continued transformation as a spiritual leader. In the Catholic and Christian tradition, this means that each of us is part of the building up of the reign of God, or as St. Paul puts it, the building up of the body of Christ. Your leadership formation is a lifelong process that encompasses your whole being. It should not be foreign or an add-on to the work you are doing, because through the process, you as leaders are being shaped into your truest, best selves. For us who are Christian, it is a process of being shaped into the likeness of Christ. It means being shaped by the values and worldview described in the rule of Saint Benedict and integrated in the mission, vision, and values of the Sisters of Saint Scholastica Monastery. Those values are similar between our sponsored ministries, but have some distinctive and important differences as well, which you will hear about in successive units. There are some common elements, however, that undergird this formation program. They are listed in the introduction to this unit and in the first reading of your unit, but I would like to develop them a little further. Spiritual grounding refers to the ability to call forth from the Catholic tradition, Benedictine charism, and your personal faith the spiritual resources and foundation that provide the larger context of meaning for your work and service to others. This call requires integrity, the courage and conviction to put these values into action. It means being willing to take risks, to ask the hard questions, and to give voice to these values, especially when confronted with difficult situations and decisions. In this process, leadership integrity requires taking time to move from action to reflection and back again to action. Integration of these values means making a commitment to cultivate the values ministry-wide through teaching, ritual, and policy and decision-making. But more importantly, it means modeling the values every day so that they can be seen in action. It means inspiring others to integrate these values until they are a part of the air we breathe. In Catholic social teaching, this includes particular attention to the care of poor and vulnerable persons, both on an individual basis and through advocacy of policies that address societal issues. It means, for our Benedictine tradition, incorporating the values of respect and justice as policies are formed and decisions are made. Action needs to be based on in-depth, accurate information and the willingness to search for the truth so that wise decisions can be made. In each of our organizations, this commitment to searching for realistic, in-depth information requires not only conducting surveys and gathering financial and other data, but also valuing input from those who are most affected by decisions. And most importantly, it requires, as Saint Benedict tells us, listening with the ear of your heart. Performance excellence refers to an integrated approach to organizational performance management that results in ever-improving delivery of value to our residents, students, and patients. It means working in your leadership position to shine a light on the ways our organizations excel in making a difference in people's lives. It also means searching for strategies that contribute to organizational sustainability and overall organizational effectiveness and capabilities. Change leadership is the ability to influence and generate enthusiasm through personal advocacy, vision, and drive. It includes the ability to access resources to build a solid platform for change. It also means promoting a spirit of hospitality, which helps others to welcome new ideas and be open to change. Through your leadership and inspiration, community building can happen as you focus and energize others to work together for the common good. To accomplish a mission and to improve performance and outcomes, there needs to be a continuous process of shaping and reshaping the organizations where you lead. This includes stewardship of resources, both human and material. It also includes reorganizing people, systems, processes, communication and reporting relationships, and incorporating a continuous process inspired and shaped by the love of learning. Finally, no matter what religious tradition practice, each of us is called to be a servant leader. In the words of Stephen Greenleaf, the servant leader is servant first. It begins with the natural feeling that one wants to serve first. Then, conscious choice brings one to aspire to lead. A servant leader focuses primarily on the growth and well-being of people and the communities to which they belong. While traditional leadership generally involves the accumulation and exercise of power by one at the top of the pyramid, servant leadership is different. The servant leader shares power, puts the needs of others first, and helps people develop and perform as highly as possible. You were selected to serve in our Benedictine ministries because you aspire to this type of leadership. We hope that through this formation program, you will continue to grow and be transformed into your best self so that you can help others to do the same. Thank you for responding to the call for personal transformation in your leadership role. There are some questions on this PowerPoint which invite reflection. Your leader may also choose to use them for dialogue. They are, how do you understand your call to leadership where you carry out your ministry? How do you see yourself called to live out the mission and values of your organization?